This is Akashvani. In the program Spotlight, as part of the series Viksit Bharat Ki Taraf Barhte Kadam, now we bring you a discussion on strengthening the cooperative sector. The participants are Dr. Hema Yadav, Director, Vaikunth Mehta, National Institute of Cooperative Management, and Aditya Shukla, Akashvani correspondent.
Union Home and Cooperation Minister Amit Shah today addressed a national conference on the initiatives taken by the Ministry of Cooperation in the initial 100 days of the third term of the Modi government. Before we start our discussion, let's listen to the Minister of Cooperation Amit Shah first, what he said in his address today.
3 साल में लगभग अब तक 60 नए इनिशिएटिव लिए गए हैं और मैं मानता हूं कि इस 100 दिन में हमने जो 10 इनिशिएटिव लिए हैं वो 10 इनिशिएटिव सहकारिता क्षेत्र को परिपूर्ण बनाने में बहुत बड़ा योगदान देंगे। इसमें से 3 आज इसी मंच से अभी एक प्रकार से सार्वजनिक किए हैं। 2 लाख प्राथमिक डेयरी, मत्स्य सहकारी समितियां और पैक्स, ये तीनों का संयुक्त एक उपबंध बनाकर हमने देश भर में भेजा था। देश की सभी राज्य सरकारों ने इसको स्वीकार किया है।
What are the key initiatives of the government in its initial 100 days for strengthening of cooperatives?
The formation and the inception of Ministry of Cooperation has laid the roadmap for strengthening cooperatives and bringing rural transformation. And today what we saw was that many initiatives have been taken. If you talk, it's in totality, there are more than 56 initiatives that have been taken by Ministry of Cooperation in the last 3 years. But today it was specifically about the achievements in the first 100 days of this new government. So these new initiatives are all geared up to bring model of development which is led by the cluster-based cooperatives, which are empowering the rural people by new opportunities for the business. And we also see that these initiatives are aimed at bringing convergence of different schemes and giving up a roadmap for a very, very long term for bringing a business diversification model and better opportunities for employment of the people through the cooperative models. These 3 initiatives out of the 10 initiatives that have been taken in the first 100 days. So today there was a launch of the guidelines on 2 lakh dairy and fishery and multipurpose primary cooperative societies. These are the guidelines on formation of these 2 lakh dairy and cooperative societies. And these 2 lakh cooperative societies are with an objective to cover the villages where there are no cooperative societies. There should be either one of these cooperative societies so that no village is left without a cooperative there. That's a very empowering thing that we see, that all the villages of the country would have either of the cooperative society. And through this cooperative society, people at the rural areas can connect with them and start a business and get a credit and access to market and access to many things which would be dispensed by the cooperatives. The second initiative was on the guidelines and the SOPs for the White Revolution 2.0. And the third one was on the cooperation amongst the cooperatives.
Okay, we will come to these 3 major initiatives that Minister of Cooperation Amit Shah launched today. So we will discuss in detail one by one. So we would like to start first with the launch of 2 lakh new multipurpose primary cooperative societies, as you already mentioned it. We would like to know more about this, like what are the impacts and how will they impact the country's cooperative sector?
There's a target to establish 70,000 new multipurpose primary agriculture cooperative societies. So these are PACs which has a multipurpose objective. So the PACs, if you see, were only dispensing the credit, but now we are talking to them as a multi-purpose one. They are multi-purpose because first there was an adoption of bylaws. Now these adoption of bylaws enable the PACs to become MPACs, multi-purpose, because they can now start the business in 25 new sectors like dairy, fishery, storage, etc. So the MPACs are multi-purpose PACs which can do a business both in goods, and they can also be dispensing services like common service centers. So these multipurpose are PACs which are now going to be the growth centers in the rural areas and bring a lot of business opportunities for the people.
You mentioned the dairy sector. Minister of Cooperation has also launched the SOP for the White Revolution 2.0 today. Can you please provide more details on the White Revolution 2.0, like what it is and how it will be beneficial for the farmers?
So what we see here is that the cooperative-led white revolution. So today it is like white revolution, which has been enabled by the milk societies at the primary level, the primary milk societies, which collect milk every day. And at the milk union, you know, they take it forward to the district milk union. And this is how the whole system works here. But the new White Revolution 2.0, which was launched today, is going to be a cluster-led, cooperative-led model, which will promote the establishment of about 56,000 multipurpose dairy cooperative societies, MDCS, during the next 5 years. And this will empower women, generate employment, expand cooperative coverage. And we also see that it's not only about the expansion only, but we also see a lot of automation taking place, a lot of technology coming in. There's a plan to bring automatic milk collection union. So these milk collection units will have automation. They will have data processing milk collection center. So these technologies will bring efficiency, transparency.
Union Minister has also talked about cooperation among cooperatives, as you already have mentioned. Please elaborate this term for our listeners and how cooperation among various stakeholders in the cooperative sector is of utmost importance.
The cooperation among cooperatives is part of the Sahakar Se Samriddhi, in which we are talking about, you know, how better cooperation can help the cooperatives. So what we see here is this, that amongst the cooperatives, there was a pilot which was carried at the Banaskantha and Panch Mahal. And in this pilot, the cooperative societies were to open up the bank accounts in the cooperative banks. So we have a three-tier structure of the cooperative banks. So we wanted to see, the pilot project was seeing that with the opening of bank accounts of the cooperative society people, it not only had increase in the account. For example, there were 8 lakh accounts opened up in 2 districts alone. And with this 8 lakh cooperatives, we see a huge transaction taking place because they were not static accounts. But we also see the transaction, that means to say payments being received in these accounts. And at the same time, we see these deposits and taking the accounts transacted by the people. So they are taking payments, deposits, we have payments being transacted. And also, when you do this cooperation among cooperatives, it also exemplifies that there were 28,000 micro ATMs which were given to them by Bank Mitras. Then also 3.8 lakh new RuPay debit cards were dispersed. And KCC to the tune of 46,000 rupees were distributed. So digital transaction has increased. And now we see 94.53 lakh of digital transaction in just 2 districts. So that's an eye opener for us, that moment you bring this kind of cooperation among cooperatives, this is just a story about 2 districts. But when you take it to 750 districts of the country, the transformation is just going to be unthinkable. So this is about the cooperation among cooperatives, where we say that the cooperative banks and the cooperative societies here should be having a kind of a relationship here. This is going to be a major thrust amongst the cooperation among cooperatives.
You talked about the banks, the payments. I want to bring here another aspect. There is availability of credit in the grassroots level, in the village level, the panchayat level. So how do you see the performance of the Modi government in providing easy credit through various schemes launched in the last 2 tenures?
Many of the research studies show, and the data also shows, that prior to the government, we see that a lot of credit is dispersed by the informal sector, which means to say the farmers would still go to the moneylender or the people in the villages to have a credit availability. There has been a big change here because now the money flows from the finance ministry to the bottom up, bottom down to the village through a channel, which is now robust with technology and transparency. And more credit is being flowing from the NABARD to the primary cooperative societies here. The whole channel is become more responsive and accountable and trustworthy also. So this network brings people to have a deposit in the cooperative societies. If you have the deposits, you can also bring the credit to the people here. So having a balance sheet in place, having the audits in place, we see that the whole credit structure in through the cooperative society, through the national banks, through the other private banks also, a formal structure has appeared here. So these credits available to the people at a very, very remunerative interest rates. So if you go and do a transaction with other kind of NBFCs, the interest rates are pretty high, could go to 25%. But when you are taking a credit from the cooperative society through these PACs, the interest rates would only be ranging 7% and even less than 7%. So these are interest rates are very competitive. The Kisan credit card, the RuPay debit cards are all different ways of dispersing the credits here. So what I say is that more and more credit through these channels is being seen here. And that has been a major initiatives in the rural areas where we see that from informal sector, we see people coming to the formal sector, which can be managed also. And I'd also like to put here also, so as we are getting digitized and getting financial inclusion, I also see that people are also very careful about having this cybersecurity in place. Now, with computerization, the cybersecurity data centers, I see not only the packs being kind of robust with these things, but I see the whole network being having this kind of security points. So more trust and more credit. And there'll be more people benefiting from these kind of schemes of Government of India taken by this government, which is empowering farmers with financial inclusions and the farmers and marginal farmers to have a better digital inclusion also.
Cooperative is a sector with immense possibility when it comes to employment generation. Am I correct?
Yes, definitely. When we talk about the cooperatives, the cooperative model for the employment is about having self-employment, because cooperatives by principle are self-governed and democratic entities. And these entities work on the principle that they are members, and the members kind of bring a share capital. And through this share capital, the cooperatives are run across the country. So the capital infusion is brought by the members themselves. So these entities at the core, as a principle, have that it's going to be a self-employment. So cooperatives are going to generate employment, because this employment would be generated by the cooperative societies. As they leverage themselves with the technology, they would open up the doors for the rural youth to take up the jobs as the CEO of the PACs. As the technology is coming, we see youth empowered by the IT knowledge to come to the PACs to manage them, to be the managers of the IT. I also see people, and with the knowledge, who can be trainers, extension workers, who can be people on the social media to help the PACs to have better access to the market. So a whole lot of opportunities are opening for skilling in a formal sector, also for the entrepreneurship. So taking cooperative model for the entrepreneurship is also what we see. We have a lot of examples where the cooperatives have initiated not only business models, but they are also playing a very responsive role for the renewable energy and wind energy, for the irrigation part, for the climate resilient agriculture, for drone technology. Cooperatives have taken the big lead. And these are all kind of points which will generate the employment, self-employment and skilling employment in the formal sectors of the cooperatives.
How important is the role of the state governments, if I say, in making the cooperative revolution successful?
Yes, cooperatives remains a state subject and facilitated by the union ministry by giving them the enabling guidelines and the policy framework. States would initiate it with its own resources, with its own acumen and the human resources that they have. States have taken up a lead, and they have all showcased a very different examples of the cooperatives. Each state has a very unique proposition of cooperatives, which also says that we should be learning from each state, because states have a very different demographic structure. If you are comparing a state from the east to west, you know, the demographic structure is different. As the demographic structure is different, the income levels are different too. So states with its own initiatives and understanding that the cooperative sector can play a big role in bringing a convergence, bringing a holistic development, the state governments are all set to bring the revolution in the cooperatives in their respective states.
How would you like to rate the performance of the government in the cooperative sector till date? And how do you see the cooperative sector evolving in the next few years in our country?
No, absolutely. The work done by the cooperative sector, which includes the federations, also includes the multi-state cooperative society, includes the state government, includes the members of cooperative societies, members of the DCCB. I mean, there's a whole kind of an ecosystem in which the cooperatives are working together. The first unprecedented march towards making these cooperatives, strengthening the cooperatives and bringing a model which can contribute to the India's trillion economy, you know, 5 trillion economy is what we aspire for. What I see is a very, very holistic and a very converging kind of a system where we have achieved a lot. Right from the sugar industry to the fishery to the dairy to the convergence of schemes to playing a key role in the sustainability, the story of India's achievement in the cooperative is unprecedented and exemplary. Regarding the evolution, yes, I do see the much earlier when the ministry was formed, it was realized that India, the cooperative sector has to embark on the technology part. We did have this a DPI in place when the digital payment infrastructure was being built, and the cooperatives banks were very quick to kind of come on board and understand the DPI. The technology stacks are coming in, and we are also understanding the Viksit Bharat themes that are there, and the policies are being made, which is going to evolve the cooperative sector as a robust system.
Thank you so much for connecting with Akashvani News.
Thank you so much.
You were listening to a discussion on strengthening the cooperative sector. The participants were Dr. Hema Yadav, Director, Vaikunth Mehta, National Institute of Cooperative Management, and Aditya Shukla, Akashvani Correspondent. This program was produced and presented by the News Services Division of Akashvani.